Bethesda.com. You're logged on.
Christ is born, Christ has died, Christ has risen. It's Ron and Fez.
Your season a given. Enjoy the best of Ron and Fez.
I don't like you anyway. I don't need your entity. You're pathetic in your own way. I feel for you. Better thinking your way. I will be hey, hey, hey. Better thinking go.
RonandFez.com. Welcome aboard Boston, Baltimore, and Las Vegas. We will try to get you updated on what's happened so far tonight.
Paulo has come in. He's been dominated all night by a couple of angry dominatrix.
They now completely shaved him down.
Shaved him down completely.
Rode him around with a saddle on his back and a bridle in his mouth, completely naked throughout the studios.
Putting things in his mouth and other places.
Mm-hmm.
As he strap on apparati.
Dressed him up in drag. Hit him with a riding crop so bad that he's still bleeding from his back and chest.
Dressed him up as Carol Channing. A messy Carol Channing, too. A trashy Carol Channing.
Yeah, but look, it was, you know, there was a problem later on.
What's that?
With the hot sauce.
The hot sauce is where it went too long.
The infamous hot sauce.
Yeah. There's always a place.
In studio with us tonight, Opie and Anthony are here from the Opie and Anthony Show in New York City.
Wouldn't have missed this one. Hell no.
Comedian Brian Regan's here from appearing at Caroline's.
Now, Opie and Anthony, for the folks listening other places outside of New York.
That's right.
You can read about them in Penthouse.
We're in Penthouse this month.
All over television this month. They are, I'll say, Fezzy, the quarterbacks of our team.
Definitely.
They tell us to go deep, we go deep. Wow. By the way, I'll point this out, too. I got on three of your Insta feedbacks this
today.
Week. I don't think any today yet. Two yesterday and one the day before.
You bastard.
Yeah. Very good.
And at one point, you guys took off and went with a long bit. I'll tell you this.
Oh, yeah.
I was Scott Shannon.
Look at that. I should have known.
I was Charles Osgood. And also, I was Jesus. So,
very good. Bravo!
And I would rather send in instant feedback than do my own show.
It's easier at home.
I'm calling my chick. Hey, listen! Turn up the radio. She's like, yeah, you have your own show. I don't know why you're here excited in the middle of the day.
The studio's completely full. We had our Christmas party tonight in New York City. This is the post-party.
Now, we are one of the dominatrix may have quit the show tonight.
There's a problem. Did both? I hope not.
I hope
we
not.
Had Mistress Vendetta and Mistress Jackie.
Are we down two or just one?
Let's find out. Just one. I mean, because Opie, they both leave, you are giving him the enema.
We're gonna need somebody to do it.
You ruined it. It's your fault.
In Bizarro world. The dominatrix want to talk to me outside the studio.
Maybe this can be smoothened out. Oh, don't walk away from us.
No, you can't do it outside
the studio. Yeah.
If they want to speak, let them come in and talk, which is fine.
I'm not apologizing to Marilyn Manson.
It'll be like when Andy Garcia walked away during that Rising Sun movie.
And what happened?
He got his head cut off.
Right.
Yeah.
What happened? I thought we were all having fun.
Yeah, you said to the dominatrix, hey, look, it's Joey Ramone.
Yeah, see?
And
that was
uncalled for and
unnecessary.
But she's a dominatrix.
I couldn't believe
how mean-spirited and
that's right. She's a dominatrix, not a punk rocker.
Right.
So they're supposed to do the enema so that we could do the funny joke off and see who drops their ass first.
A masochist might have liked that.
Yeah.
Being goofed on. Yeah.
Right.
A dominatrix.
Right.
No.
She's on the other end of the spectrum. Are you talking on
Lisa?
Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
Back in.
Are you now, really somebody mad? Could talk.
Hey, ladies.
I'm going to double click,
Everyone.
Right.
Don't curse because they'll bump out stuff. Look at the producer run to dump.
I'll apologize.
Not you.
I want to hear from
this one.
All right, easy now.
What's the matter?
It looks like they want to kill me.
Yeah, but
you know what?
All right.
All right, relax.
Relax. You gotta go. You can't treat.
You're not gonna treat.
You can't treat the big stars.
You can't treat people like that in his own studio. All right.
Did you ever hit Tom Cruise?
There you go. Bye bye.
All right.
Bye bye.
Life is good. It's the holidays. Right.
Bye bye.
Oh.
Take care. Thank you for stopping by.
Huh?
I don't even have her mic.
I'm trying to hear what's going on, but no.
It's over with.
But you're like you're a dominatrix. I didn't realize you were so sensitive. That's all.
It's not about sensitivity. It's about
you were derogatory toward her, and that we don't accept at all.
No,
we don't accept that kind of behavior from any man at all.
Why? How did that
girlfriend or your wife like that? But you know, we just don't.
Yeah, you may treat your woman like that, but we're not your woman. So
wait a minute. The way you guys treat men, you would think
it's
would be.
Okay.
It's like
they want to be treated that way.
Yeah, but you would think.
And it's consensual.
You would think
it's
the way.
Well, he, you know, he's
okay. Negotiated agreement between.
Has there ever been a time you said something to a guy or did something and they went, "Hey, enough"?
Yes. And that is why.
All right, and they tell you, and then everything's cool.
And that is why safe words are employed within the context.
All right. Well, what about a safe word? Everything's fine now.
This is not a scene. This is some imbecile who said something derogatory about us out of context.
Wait.
I'm sorry.
Don't you talk about fucking
racist.
This is out of line.
Imbecile? Is that FCC regulated?
No.
You know what? This imbecile can get the enema.
Bye-bye. Call me stupid, but I thought you guys could handle it.
Yeah. You are stupid, and we can't handle it. I don't handle derogatory relationships.
Why are you allowed to say the derogatory thing?
Bye-bye.
I don't get it.
Bye-bye.
I'm so confused.
I want to make this clear. This had nothing to do with me.
He was probably the best.
Right.
Boy.
All right. So Paulo blew his big chance. Seriously. A chance to go on with this.
Wait, I think your friend's more pissed off than you are, and
aren't you? And you and I, you could give him the enema.
I'm perfectly willing. I mean, she's...
Well, you know something? Things were said.
It's all
it
good.
Happens.
You know? Exactly.
Stick the water in his keister.
Exactly.
Why not?
Bag us.
What?
Bag
us.
Oh,
please.
Oh, boy.
Oh, please.
Oh, for the love of God, give him an enema.
Just give me an
enema. I knew.
You've never seen.
Why are you smiling?
Anything happen?
I saw you crack a smile.
Yeah,
I saw you crack a smile.
This one.
I don't.
He's not.
I don't beg
he's
no one.
Yes, he can't
and
do it.
Bye bye.
Nah, he ain't.
Bye bye.
Na 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 na. Hey, goodbye.
Can Opie?
Yes, Brian.
Can Opie subcontract the begging out to me? He can stay above the fray.
No sublighting. It's in the lease.
No, Paulo, you keep those tacky clothes. They're yours now.
I'm going to throw
out. You earned them.
I don't... I am so effing confused right now.
I know. It's hard.
There's no diplomacy.
And talk to her.
I tried, Opie. I really tried.
The one I called Joey Ramone's not even pissed anymore.
I know.
No,
Let
me just also point this out. Joey Ramone happens to be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Amen.
He's a big, big star.
I think it was more
and
the...
he's a great New Yorker.
But the more
it
I look at...
It wasn't a physical appearance.
The more I look at you, you don't look like Joey Ramone.
It was the glasses.
It's the straight hair. The straight black hair. That's
right.
It wasn't a comment on your looks.
Whatever.
Oh, my God. The guy's naked.
Well, yes, they want the clothes back.
Wait. Left us with Opie.
Hold on.
Now, girls leave. We have naked guy. Thanks, Opie. Great job. Good.
Wait, can we at least talk to the girls before they leave?
Call them back in. Call them back in. Say, all they're looking for is you to bag and let them hit you.
Guys, for the sake of your show, I will apologize, but I never apologize for anything.
You don't have to apologize.
You don't have to be
I don't understand how they got so angry to the point where they're ready to leave. They don't understand, like, this show?
No.
I don't get it.
And it can't be the first time that's happened.
Please.
Can I say one thing?
Yeah. This is a win-win situation.
Would you shut up?
Don't think that
you're
not...
What a diplomat.
Always seeing the upside. What a guy.
It is when you think about it.
Really?
All right, somebody has to step up now and say that they're going to give them the enema.
Yeah. Oh.
Are you drinking that?
It's enema juice.
No.
Oh, all right.
Joey Ramone will do the enema.
Right. Oh, she will? Yeah,
not if you keep calling her that, right. You effing a-hole.
What?
You gotta relax. You're not. Dumpy. You're no.
Are you talking to her? Are you making it happen out there?
Dumpy, I know you get upset, so you keep your cool.
Yeah, Joey Ramone wants to violate Opie.
That's
well, that ain't gonna happen.
That's not even negotiable. You know,
she can imagine that that's Opie.
It can happen tomorrow.
And give him the enema.
All right, now somebody has called on the phone that gets is a slave for these girls.
Oh, yeah?
And his name is Server.
Server.
Let's get
Server Man. Server Man.
He must run a website.
Hey, Server Man.
Keeping with the format.
Now, were you surprised that she got her feelings hurt?
No.
You thought that that could happen? See, we're not used to that type of situation.
No, the ladies, the mistresses always get total respect.
Okay, so we don't know all that. Now we'll learn.
So Opie didn't treat us with respect, did he, Server Man?
No, he did.
No.
One thing is said that upsets you, and you leave?
How is that? Please.
One thing was said.
As a mistress, if I ask you to do something, and it's not even
not
asking.
Not us. We're asking not
him. No. I'm asking one person.
Just because you're a dominatrix doesn't mean you're a master. You got the guy in the world.
You're controlling that guy, not me.
Yeah, but I control what you guys say over.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Well, then,
you don't.
Like I said, bye-bye.
Well, whatever.
You lose. You lose. Take your saggy boobs and get out of here.
I hate these effing dominatrix like this. They think if they're in a room full of men,
right,
that they dominate all the men. No,
no, that's
you
not
dominate the guy that wants to be dominated. Oh, you're so powerful. No, you dominate the guy that wants it.
Right. Hold on,
get
hold on.
Get out of here.
I wasn't a want thing.
Oh,
I just
stop.
Came in.
You
so
wanted
you
it.
Shut up.
Would this be you think any of us would be there like you are right now?
I walked into this.
All right.
Paulo.
You need some right guard.
I know.
Yeah, don't even hand in the mic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. We said we'd give you a room. We didn't say it wouldn't be the emergency room.
Sound like you guys are having a good time.
Are you still talking?
This is a private conversation.
I got to tell you this. You disgust me. You pay these girls for this?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
What, this is Mr. Server, right?
Yeah. Server Man.
Server Man.
He's Server Man.
Server Man.
Have you been with these particular dominatrix? Dominatrixes?
That's hard to say.
How do you pluralize that? Dominique Stry.
Mistress Vendetta, yeah.
Dominusa.
You have been with him?
With Mistress Vendetta, and I'm.
What does that cost you? What are you paying for this service?
Get her back.
Well, I'd rather not say.
Okay.
You'd rather not say.
Right.
How much an hour? About how much an hour?
200.
200.
What are you, what's wrong with you?
Oh, it's a lot of fun.
Give me 150. I'll come over now and slam your face in the door.
No way.
What's the difference?
What do you have done, Server Man? What do you like?
I like everything.
Hit with a hockey stick.
That saddle thing, everything?
Oh, I like everything. Whipping, cropping, all kinds of stuff. Foot worship, body worship.
You want to get it really rough, call her Joey Ramone.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, right.
No, that would ruin everything.
If you feel like you're not getting enough.
It kicks into a whole new level.
It's called the rodeo. You ever hear that one? Our word is Joey Ramone.
Different kinds of props come out.
Have they left? Have they really left?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, they left.
Yeah, they got upset.
Yeah. Ron, I see you're a lot like me when it comes to this, because you didn't have any problem telling her, hey, you know,
oh, right from the word go, yeah, because I can't stand that.
They all think this, and you watch those HBO specials on Dominatrix, and they talk about every guy like they have this feeling they dominate all men. No, you dominate the ones that want to be dominated.
Now, yeah, when she first came in, Hope, she started saying to me, hey, you, and I'll say, I said, hey, I'll punch you right in the forehead.
Hey, I will punch you right in the forehead.
Yeah, I can't take that.
Yeah, she tried to pull it right from the get, right from the intro.
They think they have this power over people, and it's all bull crap.
So, did I ruin it?
Yeah, Hope, you ruined it.
You ruined it.
Because this guy was going to get an enema. Now who's going to do it to him?
God, and I was really looking forward to checking that out.
Is there any volunteers? We have a room full of people from the Christmas party.
I'm thinking Lisa.
Lisa.
Lisa, what do you think?
Just say yes.
Well, if you weren't chatting during our show, maybe you'd know what you're talking about.
Lisa, say yes.
I put your condom away, Paul.
Just say yes loudly.
Lisa.
Say yes.
Just...
All right.
Lisa's going to
get Paulo the enema.
Has agreed to get Paulo the enema.
Yeah. Hey, step up to the plate.
As long as Opie doesn't call her Iggy Pop and drive her, drive her into the street crying.
Wow, I didn't realize what I was walking into.
You ruined it.
I ruined it.
Just come in and sit down and all hell breaks loose.
It's funny, we were waiting for Opie for the